Arkansas put an innocent man to death? That's the question raised by newly tested DNA evidence. And thank you for joining us at 10. I'm Craig O'Neill.
And I'm Arlisa Goldsmith. Liddell Lee maintained his innocence throughout his life up to the day of his execution.
What's good, guys? Welcome back to Crime Sober Day 14. 14 whole days, guys. One more day to go. Wow. Can't believe it. Like, seriously. Now, today's episode, I came across by looking on Yahoo. Ironically, out of nowhere, a news article reported that a man that had been executed, new DNA evidence came out that his DNA was not a match on the murder weapon and a bloody t-shirt. I was like, what's this case? And I need to know more about it. And you guys know I really don't dibble dabble into death rows as such. I only did Rodney Reed and I touched on the Julius Jones death row case. And now this one, as a man who already been executed by the name of Dell Lee, who was 51 at the time of the execution, I was just shocked to find out what had happened. You know, just to read and figure out what had taken place. Now, Liddell was convicted of capital murder for the death of 26-year-old Deborah Reese in Jacksonville, Arkansas, back in 1993. Now, he was executed in 2017 and he had been on death row for over 20 plus years. Now, throughout this time frame, a lot has transpired with legal team and the Innocence Project trying to get DNA from the murder weapon and the blood tested. That was a whole shebang in itself. But let's get back to the beginning of how this even occurred. Now, Liddell Lee is not a saint from what I have read. And you guys know I keep it real. If I always read something, I'm like, okay. But it makes you wonder, did he murder Deborah Reese? Now, Liddell does have a background of sexual assaults and rape. He was accused of 3 sexual assaults, and 2 of those he was convicted of. Then he was tried for another rape and murder, which the jury could not come to a verdict. But then the Deborah Reese case came, and that's how Liddell Lee ends up getting capital murder execution. So prosecutors didn't feel the need to retry him due to that verdict coming down. Well, let's get into the Deborah Reese case. Deborah was a 26-year-old mother and wife, and she was at home on February 6th of 1993, and her husband had given her a tire plumber. Other articles state a bat, but then new articles state it was a tire plumber, and this was set to protect her, I guess, just because of the area and because she was home by herself. So her husband, you know, wanted her to be safe. And you guys got to think, back in 1993, times are very different than now with new technology, security systems of such. Well, on this day, it has been stated that Deborah was sexually assaulted and she was murdered, and she was plunged 36 times with this object that her husband gave her, you know, to protect herself. And that is pretty much that story. Eyewitnesses had stated that they seen Liddell coming from Deborah Reese's home. And then it had been reported that, I guess, he either stole $300 that she had, but that's just what has been written in reports. I didn't see anything to validate that, but that is just what had been stated. And as I read his background, I'm like, okay, well, this man was out here doing sexual assaults, you know, crimes of that nature. Sir, okay, well, maybe he did, you know, commit this crime. You know, eyewitnesses pinpoint him there, and because of his prior background. So in 1995, that is when he was sentenced to death. And he had been sitting on death row for a very long time. But throughout that process, it would take his attorneys trying to get the DNA evidence tested, because Liddell has always maintained his innocence. He has stated that he did not murder or rape, you know, Miss Reese. So throughout this time, like I said, they were trying to get DNA tested, and prosecutors basically said,
new evidence shows that Liddell Lee may not have been the only person there at the time of Deborah Reese's death.
In fact, attorneys say that there was no physical evidence that connected Lee to her murder.
The DNA wouldn't matter because 3 to 4 people had basically seen, you know, Liddell. And I'm just like, okay, maybe. And my thing is, I play devil's advocate. Okay, he's not a saint, but maybe he was around the neighborhood. It has been said that he was a neighbor. Maybe he was just trying to peep in the house. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But to say you've seen that person doesn't always mean that the person may have killed that person. He was working with, you know, before his execution, the Innocence Project and the ACLU to get the hairs found at the crime scene and the DNA tested, because they were never previously tested. Like I said previously, it was as such that it didn't matter, because it went off background, it went off eyewitnesses. So DNA in this case in the beginning just did not matter at all. And Lee actually had 2 trials because his first attorney didn't even bring up the case of the DNA or his disability, because he had the fatal syndrome and intellectual disabilities as well. And then it gets so good, y'all. The judge residing on the case was having an affair with the freaking assistant prosecutor, y'all. I read that and was like, what? So like, it was like a whole lot of stuff going on, I think, honestly. And then y'all, Lee's attorney was drunk in court. So that's why he was able to get a whole new trial. It was just like a lot of things going wrong. As I was reading this, I was like, this sounds like something out of a movie. Like, you have the judge basically having sex with the prosecutor, the assistant prosecutor, then your own attorney is drunk in court. Like, sir, seriously, you're slurring. And oh my goodness, I was reading that, just like, I would be horrified as the person being tried for this crime. Like, seriously, dude. So because this DNA was never tested, Liddell Lee was executed. He was executed in 2017, right? It had also been reported that Arkansas has not done any execution since 2005. It is now this time frame, 2017, and the lethal injections were going bad by April 30th of this year. So they had to hurry up and do executions. Some of those individuals actually got to stay, but it was kind of like they didn't care about testing his DNA. They wanted to execute him. They wanted him to go. And so he was executed. He did not have any last moment, no last final words. He did a Holy Communion, and then he was dead by 11:30-ish p.m. that night. And it would take literally, 18, 19, 20, 21, 4 years later for that DNA to finally be tested. And it had come out that this DNA matched an unknown male. And so it was from the murder weapon and that blood, I guess, that was wrapped around the murder weapon as well. So the Innocence Project released a statement saying that, you know, there was no DNA connecting Liddell to the Deborah Reese murder. And of course, on the flip side, people who presided on this case still believe that Liddell was the murderer. From this, you know, I had read that they believe that they did not put the wrong person to death. But it does make you wonder, though. I get the whole eyewitness thing, but at the same time, if his DNA is nowhere inside of this murder, and mind you, Deborah was plunged to death, beaten literally 36 times with this thing, you would think that there would have been blood on Liddell or anything, you know, or the DNA under Deborah's nails, you know, or something of that nature, but there wasn't. So maybe he did rob, steal some money from her. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? But did he murder her? I don't know. This one's a tough one because when you read everything and you're looking at it, it's like, okay, you go down the past, you go down to the court proceedings. It was kind of like they were just trying to railroad him because of his past. But the DNA, and then you didn't want to test the DNA, but then the DNA comes out years later that this is an unknown male's DNA here, not her husband's. So you know what I'm saying? Like, you think, oh well, maybe it's her husband's because he gave her the murder weapon, you know, he gave her that item. So as I read, it says that the testing concluded that there is a moderate support that blood on Lee's left shoe could belong to Reese. And so the attorney general pretty much says that there is a shadow of doubt in that the execution of Liddell Lee was what it was, and that, you know, he hopes our family can be able to grieve after that many years. It's just a tough thing because it just makes you wonder about the DNA. And then I think the hairs, it was 6 hairs that was found, but 5 of them were definitely not Liddell's, but one of them was inconclusive. So that can't even determine if it was in fact him or not. It's a crazy story. As I read it, I was just like, I don't even know what to think because it's wild, like wild as hell. I mean, yeah, I don't know. I don't have any words. You wonder about the death penalty. That's why I say sometimes I'm just not necessarily for it, regardless of the crime, because some people literally die and they don't commit the crimes. I'm not saying that Liddell didn't or did, but just you take his case and you think, like, it makes you just wonder, did he do it? You know what I'm saying? Regardless of his past. Did he do this crime? Did he kill Deborah Reese? A white woman. Did he kill her? But if he didn't, he shouldn't have been executed for her crime. Now, if he did those other crimes, okay, yes, he needs to serve those time and deal with those. You know what I'm saying? That's why I said it's a hefty topic to discuss because there's literally no right or wrong answer, because somebody will feel very differently about a man like Liddell who has a past of sexual assault who needs to be killed. You know what I'm saying? Versus someone who just, maybe he didn't, if he didn't do it, okay, how can we necessarily prove that he did not do it? Because these things take time in court proceedings and stuff like that. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts. It's a wild one. I just wanted to share it. I just thought it was crazy as it came across my screen on Yahoo. And I was just like, well, that's interesting. Like, that's just crazy. Bye, guys. I'll see you tomorrow.